get this one and I'm holding on. I can't be replaced. I just take a sip when it's spit. We on check for the win. Celebrate the win again. Celebrate the win again. Take a sip when it's spit. We on check for the win. Celebrate the win again. Celebrate the win again. It is triumphant. Look, let's bump it. Don't mind me seizing the moment. Energy up, my body burning. And my stomach keep up tight. Stop moving, I can't control it. All my last breath and I can't hold it. You gotta give it all I got. This for the ones that think I'm joking.
It's the NFL on EA Sports, and we are a mile high at Broncos Stadium in Denver, Colorado. Just a short time ago, sounds loud enough to reverberate across the Rockies. They're ready for football in Denver as the Broncos get set to do battle with the Pittsburgh Steelers. And off we go from Denver. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And he'll be dropped at the 21-yard line. So bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision. Loses him about 4 yards.
They're on the 21-yard line.
Getting a yard on the game's first play at second down.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. Really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
On second and nine, Lock. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Mike Hilton. And he brings this one back. It's a pick six for a Steeler touchdown.
On for the point after.
And the defense could not have written a much better script than that. First drive, pick six.
The offense never got a chance to really get oiled up there, did they? But the defense, they certainly got in gear. What a big-time play and a great way for them to start.
And now the offense, they've got to turn things around and figure this out because your backs are on the ground real quickly.
Yeah, usually when you're starting the game, getting the ball, 0-0 is the score you're worried about. Now the second time you get it, you're already down a touchdown.
Take over first and 10.
The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. They'll start on the ground. This is Gordon on first down. Gets this to the 24 for a gain of 4.
Melvin Gordon.
Well, at the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a 4-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
They'll come up second and six now from the 24. Now the first carry here for Phillip Lindsay. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. 6 yards to pick up, and that's a first down.
Denver Broncos.
Shotgun snap to Lock. On the slant, completes to Sutton. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That one going for a gain of 11 and a Bronco first down. Lock on target there to Fant, the tight end. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first. Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. Cortland Sutton was the man he was looking for. And that'll bring up second down.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
On second down now, it's Gordon. He's got the first down here inside the 30, and he'll be taken down at the 26. That one good for a first down pickup of 18 yards. Gordon. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown, so a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now. Hopefully get to the perimeter later, and let's face it, you could do worse than a 4-yard run on first down.
Here's a throw out wide complete to his running back right side. A minimal gain there on the eighth play of the drive.
In order for the screen pass to break big, a lot of things have to come together and be well executed. But all it takes is one small thing to go wrong and keep it from being a big game.
Open man, he completes it to Judy. And able to get him down, but he does reach the five. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. First and goal, Melvin Gordon. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Denver score. A 5-yard touchdown run. And the Broncos are an extra point away from tying the football game. On here, Brandon McManus for the point after. It's up and good. So these teams match touchdowns here in the first quarter, and we're tied 7-7.
Brandon McManus to kick off for Denver.
So I'll leave it at 7 now as they kick it away. Taken in the end zone, and this will not be returned. It'll come out to the 25
at their own 25-yard line.
Steelers with a first and 10 at their 25-yard line. He'll set up to throw from the gun. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Pressure, and that's certainly going to be a key to this game going forward. And that time, they were able to get in there and influence the throw. Remember, quarterbacks got to get rid of it. They don't have the tuck rule that they can fall back on anymore.
Complete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. First carry for the 2018 Pro Bowler, James Conner. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7 past the 30 to the 32.
Well, this play sequence was really kind of called in reverse. Incomplete pass on first and 10. Nice run on second and 10 when probably everyone was expecting him to throw the football. Now, if you're the defense, what are they going to do on third down? You're a little off balance.
And that one drops incomplete as he got popped as he was throwing it.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
Some indecision on getting the punt team out there, and they're going to get a delay. So that'll back them up 5. Oh, a big decision here early. Look at this. They're going to go for it on their own side of the field. They'll indeed go for it with Roethlisberger. To his running back, complete. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. Give him credit. They knew what they wanted to dial up on fourth. They executed it for 9 yards, and the offense stays out there. These two teams all tied after one.
With the score tied 7-7. I got homies that can sleep with
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Now Connor on the toss, left side. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. The Steeler first down on the pickup of 11 yards. Interior of that line blocked really well on that run, but also the two tight ends, they blocked well too.
Not only have they scouted the line of scrimmage, with their agility, they can get upfield and hit moving targets like linebackers, defensive backs. They do a really good job helping out the running game.
And now a throw here secured by his running back out of the backfield. The catch and run there, good for 16 and a first.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
On the tackle that time, Shelby Harris.
And this is why aggressive defensive coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D lineman to make the play.
On second and nine, Roethlisberger setting up the screen. This is Samuels. And he was able to shed one tackle, but could not get away from there. Only a yard there. Sniffed out well defensively, and it brings up third.
Third down.
From the gun, it's Roethlisberger. And that's going to be incomplete. The contact there enough to jar that ball free, and it brings up fourth down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting him before the ball arrived, and I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And they're able to get this one past the 30 to the 25-yard line. That's a fourth down pickup of 10 yards and an opportunity certainly missed on the defensive side.
No, but I'm on this every day.